Here comes your shaved ice. You need some what? Oh my goodness, she finished her bowl. Xena, you want some more? Hold on tight to her. I have her. I'm sorry if she starts to bark.
It's that squirrel.
It's all gone. Squirrel's all gone. All gone. Look, Daddy got ice. Look, Xena. Xena, look, Daddy. Look, Xena. Xena. Look, Daddy got shave ice. Come on. Xena. Is it over there bugging people? Just regular water. Xena. Here.
Oh.
Xena, down. You know better.
Some of the answers are being discovered just ahead. To help us maintain these carefully controlled ecosystems, and for your safety, please remain seated in your boat at all times. Where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce healthy harvests now and into the future. The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, banana, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petal, are edible. The starch from the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. One day, many of these lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as